Dean Gibson wants Australians to wake up and face the reality of Indigenous incarceration.
We just thought the time was right to sit down and look at the big story of incarceration in Australia, the big story of injustice and justice system, and really shine a spotlight on that and understand where we are today as a nation.
The Guugu Yimithirr filmmaker's latest project was 3 years in the making. He says it's tough, but it had to be done.
It's a powerful film. It can be gut-wrenching at times. Incarceration Nation clearly has some big, heavy and challenging themes for the audience. Now, should we walk away from it and not deal with it? No. Should we step into it and actually understand it, get an understanding of where we're coming from today and kind of the laws that have got us to where we are today? Absolutely, we need to step into it and try and understand what that is and understand what we can do about that.
The documentary uses historical archives to show the current situation is deeply rooted in history.
Unless you understand the context of which someone's incarceration, and that includes the history, you're never going to be able to deal with the issue in the future.
Wani and Kalkadoon barrister Josh Creamer says Australia needs to understand how decades of government policies have affected our people and led to this crisis.
Why does this family have 3 or 4 generations of people going into prison? Grandparents removed, great-grandparents removed under the Protection Acts. Why is this family here today? That has consequences for the generation today and the future generations if we don't deal with it. And that's really what I wanted to bring. I wanted people to understand why issues are occurring today so that we can actually make an impact and ensure that we address things for tomorrow.
I want people to watch it. I want people to sit down and open their eyes.
Journalist Karina Hogan has worked with women who are incarcerated. This issue is close to her heart. She says it's crucial to include the story of First Nations women.
And the fact that they are the fastest growing prison population in the world is something that needs to change.
The crew also worked closely with families who've lost loved ones in custody.
Because that's the day they took my baby away.
We spoke to every family involved in the film.
Dean Gibson and his team hope people will watch with open hearts and minds, as hard as that will be.
It's going to be felt, there's no doubt about it, and it's going to shake and it's going to make people really have a good hard think about the story and the situation in Australia. And I think the first thing that I want people to do is really just listen and understand. I hope that it'll change hearts and change minds. We can sit and talk about systems and talk about changes and models and ways forward, but until people's hearts and minds really understand the impact of it and the truth of it, I don't think we can really step forward with a real understanding of what is at stake and what can be done to change that. And I think, so for me, the impact is changing hearts, changing minds.